Hey people, it's me again. So, anyways, I don't really remember exactly which date it was, but I know it was right around this time when I finally said I'm gay to myself. You know? And it was kind of like a weight lift off my shoulders at that point. You know? And this was like 20 years ago. Just doesn't really seem like it's been like 20 years since I've been out. You know? But it just kind of feels weird to think that a lot of this other stuff that was going on lately has been like a certain amount of years ago at that point. You know? But I'm trying to remember if there was a video that I uploaded about 5 years ago where I talked about being out for 15 years. I probably think there was, but I probably just don't really remember exactly, or if there was, I don't think I even remember if I had like a video on YouTube where I talked about being out for 10 years. I was at that kind of point where I just didn't know what I wanted to do with YouTube, and you know, 10 years ago at that point. I do remember doing a video where I was talking about being out for 5 years. Yeah. But I think in some ways I was trying to keep a brave face about all of that. But to tell the truth, I was going through certain things, you know, when it came to that time, you know, back about in 08, you know, and I was kind of in that vulnerable position because this was like right when the whole thing with marriage equality and all of that, when it came to like Prop 8, you know, and a lot of us just assumed that the whole Prop 8 was going to fail and all, but little did we know it was going to pass just barely. And the fact that all these homophobic people were gloating and all, and saying like, screw you, you, like that, like, traditional marriage prevails and blah, 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 blah. But little did they know that 5 years later, that marriage equality prevailed at that point, and it was restored here in California, and nothing happened. No huge devastating earthquake that divided the earth and swallowed California whole or something like that. As they prayed for that in some ways. And then of course, you know, 5 years later, you know, the whole marriage equality still is around, you know, even though like Trump became president, everybody was afraid that Trump was gonna turn the country upside down and all. But little do we know, it's now it's like it's the Biden administration's turning the country upside down. And now everything's all flipped around because the left has lost their mind, and now it's kind of like the right has become a little bit more saner. Even though they're still you know, far right or alt right at that point, they didn't really have that much of a voice on other things there. So, what got me to that whole point, it's a bit of a long story, but I think for the cliff note there was just that I just wasn't feeling okay, you know, when it came to that year, because there was a lot of stuff that was happening. It was just a little bit too personal. Yeah. And at one point, I had gone back to living in Irving, Texas at that point there, because it was just more of a distraction of my problems that I was facing. And we were on one of those trips to go to like San Antonio and Austin. I think we'd gone to like San Antonio first, then Austin on the way back. Yeah. So at one point I just needed like some me time. Yeah. And which is what I'm like doing here now, having some me time. And I was like reaching that precipice and that precipice, and it just the words needed to come out of my mouth. The word "I'm gay" to myself. And I finally said that sort of thing. But it wasn't really like completely finished. You know, I had to say "I'm gay" to a lot of other people just for it to kind of stick around at that point. So by the end of the month, I was kind of at that point where it's kind of like semi-out, where I wasn't really out to straight people just yet. But at the end of that month, that was when I finally was out to certain people that weren't gay at that point. And it was just a weight lift off my shoulders and all of that there. Yeah. But considering all of that, there was a lot of other stuff that was going on. You know, like the whole political climate was changing, you know, it was the height of the Bush years and the height of the time where marriage equality was being threatened, you know. And we'd gotten that really close to like maybe it was like, what was it, like 30 states to constitutionally ban marriage equality. We were like at that point, you know, if there were more states that had joined up, then marriage equality would have been realized. But that was like almost 10 years ago when the tide was starting to change. When all these ballot initiatives that also approved marriage equality in 3 states and rejected a marriage ban. And Prop 8 case going to the Supreme Court and overturning all of these, Defense of Marriage Act and all of these bans on marriage equality, and now we have marriage equality. But as far as this goes, it's still going to be here regardless of that sort, no matter how the Supreme Court has been set up at this point. Yeah. I don't know what is going to be in store for me in another 5 years, because then it's going to be, then I would say like that I've been out for like 25 years, 30 years, and so on and so forth. But at one point, you know, I also knew people that have been out for even longer than that. There was this guy, Josh, that I met while I was attending Northlake College in Irving, Texas. And at one point where he had mentioned that he's been out since he was 13. And Josh was about like a year older than me. And he was able to be out at age 13 in the rural part of West Texas. You know, takes a lot of balls for that matter. But I knew some people that have been out since like the 80s or even the 70s. When that sort of thing occurred to you. But, as I said before about all that kind of stuff, now like the left has kind of gotten too far with being supportive and all, to the point where it causing people to lose support. You know, when you're wanting to like tell kids about what it's like to be gay when they're not in an appropriate age to even know about that sort of thing, you know, we should just stick to having them know about that once they're in an appropriate age, you know, when you're in that pre-pubescent stage, you know, the tween age, teenage years. Not when they're 5 or 6 or whatever. When they barely have any idea about what it is. And that was sort of the reason why, in a way, like parts of the left and parts of the right coming together against the far left. Just as much as sometimes there are parts of the right and left that come again that join against the far right. You know. And that's something that's what's going to happen there. What is happening here, there's some sort of Marxist revolution. There is like a revolution, but it's going to be the end of this two-party system. Because a lot of people are now starting to realize that the two-party system is fucking load of bullshit. You know? And we deserve better than just, you know, having the choice of the do-nothing Democrats or the do-nothing Republicans. And all they just do is just waste time and energy. So, anyways, I guess this is probably it for now. I feel like I have to also take some time, you know, focusing on other things at this point. You know, but this is just like what happened like 10 years ago, where I essentially stopped uploading videos on YouTube at that point. You know, but at the time around 2014 was where I did all these little short videos there, and then I ended up going back to uploading videos on YouTube. But it is kind of strange to me, like it's been like that long since I had uploaded vlogs on YouTube. It was right around this time, a little bit later, where I started to get more views on YouTube through my vlogs at that point. And that was back in 07 and then 08, where I started to get a little bit more involved in such things. You know? But it just feels a little bit weird. So anyways, I guess that's probably it.